With all the heat that Tether is getting lately, I think it's time to take a look at a much superior stablecoin alternative. That's because I believe it is the most promising stablecoin platform in the market. Basically, MakerDAO is the company or the platform, while DAI is the issued stablecoin. Like I said before, there are three types of stablecoins: fiat collateralized, crypto collateralized, and algorithmic or non-collateralized. But actually, there's a fourth type. I never talked about it because it is very rare. In fact, I've never heard of any stablecoin using this model until DAI. DAI is currently a crypto collateralized stablecoin, but soon, after multi-collateral DAI is released into mainnet, it's gonna become one of the first hybrid stablecoins. It will blend all three other models in one. So the MakerDAO system has two currencies: DAI, which is the stablecoin that is pegged to the US dollar. Please note that this is only pegged, not backed, by USD, meaning the system is stabilizing its value to a 1-to-1 ratio with the dollar, but currently it's backed by Ethereum only. Soon, DAI can be backed by many different types of assets, including fiat currencies, precious metals, and other tokens. MKR, on the other hand, is the governance token. Its holders have voting rights and it is architected in a decentralized manner. Because of its role in keeping the system together, the price of MKR is volatile, unlike DAI. So let's jump into the best part: how to create DAI. Being a permissionless system, anyone can create DAI. The process is pretty simple. All you have to do is send Ether to a MakerDAO smart contract, and then it becomes what we call a CDP. If you haven't heard of CDP, it stands for Collateralized Debt Position. Just a fancy name, but it's merely a smart contract. So now that you've sent your Ether as collateral, you are now entitled to receive a proportional amount of DAI tokens. Notice how I say proportional, not equal, amount of DAIs. That's because you must over-collateralize in order to absorb price fluctuations of your asset. Let's say you sent $150 worth of Ether to the CDP. You're not gonna get $150 worth of DAI too. You're allowed to specify any amount of DAI you want in return, as long as you remain over-collateralized. Example, having $100 worth of DAI backed by $200 worth of Ethereum means that you have 200% collateralization. You could opt to have 150% and get more DAI for the same amount, but the risk of getting liquidated would be higher. Choice is yours. I'm not sure if it's even allowed at this point. And liquidation has a penalty you have to pay, so once you've created your CDP, you cannot retrieve the underlying Ether collateral until you close the said CDP. And you can only do that by paying back the issued DAI plus a stability fee. We'll get back to the stability fee later, but first let's talk about how you can potentially profit from this mechanism. For instance, let's say you send some Ether to the Maker platform to create a CDP. Let's say you collateralize by 200%, you'll receive half the amount in DAI. So in this scenario, you already have your Ether locked up as debt collateral, as well as some DAIs. What you can do here is sell that DAI and get more Ether. Now you have plus 100% more Ether than you originally had. And you can do whatever you want with it. You could either add it to your CDP, or you could just keep it in your wallet, or maybe trade it, whatever. What's left to do then is wait. Wait for Ethereum to increase in price. Once you're satisfied with the price increase, you may close your CDP. Therefore, you pay up your debt and then your Ether can be reclaimed. Now you might be wondering, how did I profit? I paid back the debt that I owed in order to get my Ether back. What's new? Well, that's because you paid back in DAI, which has a stable price. Your Ether, on the other hand, which was locked up, is not stable, and you waited for it to rise and reap the rewards. But what if the opposite happens and Ether's price falls? Well, you're in deep shit. That's why it's better to create CDPs in an uptrend market than in a downtrend market. Last year was the worst bear market, so it would have been a really bad idea to create CDPs. But they did. This year, things are looking up. We've seen short uptrends lately, and the fundamentals are getting stronger by the day. Now would be a good time to create CDPs. Of course, that's not financial advice. Now back to the stability fee, which I left out earlier for simplicity's sake. But actually, in order to issue DAI, you need to pay a stability fee which was raised very recently to 19.5% per year. This is payable in MKR, the governance token, which by the way gets burned afterwards, decreasing the circulating supply. Alright, let's recap the steps in profiting from DAI. Loan your Ether to get some DAI, use the DAI in any way you want, repay the DAI when you're ready to get your collateral back. Cha-ching! So now we know how you can convert your Ethereum CDP to DAI. But we have to wonder, how does DAI remain stable when Ethereum is very volatile, not to mention it crashed by 90% last year? This is handled by the so-called target rate feedback mechanism. Basically, it allows the system to remain in stable equilibrium by automatically adjusting the price of each DAI relative to the target price. The target price is simply the price we want DAI to be. So like I said earlier, DAI is pegged to the US dollar. Three scenarios can happen. Scenario 1. Current DAI price is the same as target price, so no change required. Scenario 2. Current DAI price is higher than the target price. In this case, the system has to release additional DAI to make the price go down. The mechanism will make it cheaper to create DAI, which incentivizes users to create more of it, and so demand goes down, bringing the price with it. Scenario 3. Current DAI price is lower than target price. In this scenario, the system has to withdraw DAI from the market to make its price higher. The mechanism will make sure that DAI creation becomes more expensive, so less DAI will be created, and so demand goes up, bringing the price with it. The target rate feedback mechanism is great for keeping the DAI stable, while over-collateralization cushions it from immense price swings. But that's not all. MakerDAO has a feature called global settlement, which is its last line of defense. This is a process in which the system freezes, meaning no CDPs can be created nor liquidated, and transactions are stopped. Then, the process of returning all collateral back to its owners begin. So basically, it's a global shutdown which unravels the MakerDAO platform while making sure that all DAI holders and CDP users receive the net value of assets that they are entitled to. And it can only be triggered by a set of global settlers, which are of course chosen by the MKR holders, which makes the whole process relatively decentralized. A global settlement must only be triggered if 1. There is a security breach such as hacks or cyber attacks, 2. If there is a black swan event, which is an occurrence that is impossible to predict but has catastrophic ramifications. The DAO hack on Ethereum is an ideal example for this. And 3. When there are system upgrades. For instance, there is a planned global settlement to occur once the system upgrades to multi-collateral DAI. As we've talked about, the MakerDAO platform only supports Ethereum as collateral. But accepting only one type of asset without any other alternatives is bad for the system, especially if it's a very volatile asset like Ethereum. Despite the system being admirably resilient, the MKR holders had to vote a few times to increase the stability fee in order to restrict the supply of DAI and drive up the price back to $1. Currently, the stability fee is 19.5%, which is really high. I'm not sure how much it used to be, but according to CoinDesk report, they've been incrementally increasing it for weeks. My best guess is that it was somewhere below 10% before, but take that part with a grain of salt. But to be fair, this isn't the MKR holders' fault. they are simply reacting to the law of supply and demand. The decision to increase the stability fee might incentivize some users to close their CDPs and burn their DAI tokens, thereby stabilizing the price. On top of that, it might discourage users from creating more DAIs too. So far it's working. DAI is stable at $0.99 on CoinMarketCap at the time of this recording. But the problem is if people speculate that Ethereum is going to pump hard this year. Because you know, crypto winter is over and Ethereum is still number 2 among cryptocurrencies. If people believe that Ethereum is gonna, let's say, triple in price anytime soon, they wouldn't care too much about the 19% stability fee. Because what is 19% fee to 300% profits, right? And that can destabilize DAI. This is one of the reasons why multi-collateral is very important. We can't have the risk concentrated on one volatile currency. If we could spread the risk to include precious metals, fiat money, properties, and other assets, then DAI's price won't be easily influenced by the speculation of Ethereum holders. Not that I don't like Ethereum, I love it. Anyways guys, thanks for watching, catch you on the flip side.